I would like to thank the organizers for giving me an opportunity to speak here. So I'll be talking about law of fractional logarithms for extrema of Airy processes. So I'll start the talk by saying what the Airy processes are. So basically I'll be talking about these two processes, Airy 2 and Airy 1, which will be denoted by this A2 and A1 throughout the talk. And these are basically stationary stochastic processes on R, which arise as scaling limits of various integrable models in the KPZ universality class. So in the previous talk, there was mention of this KPZ universality class. So so one special feature is that the finite dimensional distribution of these are given by these explicit formulas. So in particular, so if I take a finite tuple like this, then the joint distribution, that the probability that this AI of RK is at most SK, this is given by this notation, which is basically this alternating sum involving integration and determinants. So this is a complicated sum, but and also this K AIs, these are integral kernels on this Hilbert space. So the explicit form of these kernels will not be important to us, but the key point is that we can, the distributions can be written as the explicit formulas. So everything can be written explicitly, okay? So there are some nice properties of these Airy processes. So first, I'd like to point out that Airy 2 process was introduced by Praffer and Swan in 2002 in context of PNG droplet. And Airy 1 process was introduced by Sasamoto in 2007 in context of TASEP. And also this Airy 2 process is actually the scaling limit of the height functions of TASEP starting from step initial condition. And Airy 1 process is the scaling limit of the height function in TASEP starting from periodic initial condition. So we will not be talking about this TASEP scenario, but this is one of the examples that where it arises as a scaling limit of an integrable model. And as I said, both these processes are stationary, and also this one-dimensional marginals are also well understood. So this is GUE traceivadum and GOE traceivadum. So this was also mentioned in the previous talk. So this is denoted by traceivadum 2, TW2, and this is denoted by TW1. And also these are also very well understood distribution. There are explicit formulas for the distributions, but again, that will not be necessary for this talk. Also both the processes are ergodic. So both of these models are, processes are well understood, and there are many interesting properties one can study. So we are going to consider this following question. So since these are stationary stochastic processes on R, then one can consider this object, which is the maximum or minimum over an interval, and one can, so that's an interesting object to study. And in particular, we will be interested in this following question, that if I fix beta equal to 1 or 2, so in either case, does there exist this kind of function, say f beta or g beta, such that if I look at the maximum over an interval 0 to t of this either Airy1 and Airy2 process, and if I scale it by this function f beta, then this limit goes to a constant, in particular 1 almost surely. So in particular, what is the growth of this function? And similar question can be asked for the minimum. So now, so this is a LIL type of question that's asked in the case of simple random walk in usually. And this question about this maxima was raised by Poo in 23. And he answered this question fully in case of the Airy1 process. So he identified this function. And for the Airy2 process, he considered this maxima, but he gave a partial answer in that case. But in both the cases, he established a law of fractional logarithm. So in particular, this f beta, he found out it to be log t to the 2/3. So in classical LIL, we have this log log, so that's why it is iterated. But here it is a fractional logarithm. So this is the result we have. So the result is as follows, that for beta equal to 1 and 2, this limit, that the maxima by this log t to the 2/3, this is equal to this constant almost surely. So in when beta equal to 1, this is 3 by 4 square root 2 to the 2/3, and when beta equal to 2, this is 3 by 4 to the 2/3. And similarly, we have for the minima as well. So when so for this minima, the function is actually log t to the 1/3. and this limit is equal to minus 3 beta squared to the 1/3 almost surely. So when beta equal to 1, this is minus 3 to the 1/3, and when beta equal to 2, this is minus 12 to the 1/3. Okay, so here is what Poo did in his work. So what he proved is that he completely proved the result for the maximum of Airy 1. And for the maxima of Airy 2, he proved the upper bound. So he got the 3/4 to the 2/3, but for the lower bound, he proved this 1/4 to the 2/3. And for the upper bounds, his method was to analyze the tail estimate for the maximum of Airy 1 and Airy 2 process. But for the lower bound, his bounds involved these covariances. And in case of Airy 1, this covariance actually decay very fast. So this is like super exponentially. And that's why he could ignore this term, and he got the correct lower bound in that case. But for the Airy 2, this decay is much slower. So it's like 1/x². And that's why this he got a loss of 1/4 to the 2/3. And also he did not consider the minima case. So what we do is we complete this picture. We prove the lower bound for the Airy 2 process, and we also prove the result for the minimum. Okay. So now I'll explain how we prove this, but is there any question? Okay, so what we'll do is that we'll not solve this problem in the Airy process case. We'll go to a prelimiting object, and this is last process percolation. So it was described in great details in the previous talk. So here what we do is that we take the Z2 lattice, and we take IID exponential 1 random variables. And for any path, the passage time of the path is defined as sum of the weights of the vertices that lies on the path. Okay, and so I'll define these following two quantities. So one is point to point last passage time. So this is exactly what was defined in the last lecture. So this is, if I fix two vertices U and V, then last passage time is, I will consider all paths which are up and right between U and V. So this is one of such example. And I'll consider all such path, and I'll maximize this quantity L of gamma. So this is denoted by TUV. And one can also define this line to point last passage time. So which is basically I am fixing this line x plus y equal to r, this anti-diagonal line, and I'm considering a fixed point. And I'm looking at all path gamma, which is starting from some point on this LR and ending at some fixed point U. And then again, I'm maximizing this quantity L of gamma. So these will be two object of interest for us. And so before going to the connection with Airy process, I want to just explain briefly why this model is interesting. So one thing is, so this is basically the model that I described. It's just rotated in the 45 degree. So because it's a convenient coordinate system to consider for last passage percolation. So this is the x equal to y direction, and this is the anti-diagonal direction. And then this blue curve is basically the passage time of the space-time coordinate. And so last passage percolation with exponential weight belongs to this KPZ universality class. So one special feature is that it shows this 1/3 and 2/3 fluctuation. So what it basically means is that if I scale in the space direction by t to the 2/3 and in the time direction by t to the 1/3, then there is sort of a limiting object. So I'll say what it rigorously means, at least in this context. And also, I defined the last passage percolation for exponential weights. It makes sense with any general IID distribution, and it is conjectured that all that model should show this 1/3 and 2/3 exponent, but these are not proved. But in case of exponential LPP or geometric LPP, these are integrable model or exactly solvable model where these one can analyze exact formulas to get these exponents 1/3 and 2/3. Okay. Okay, so now we have these results. So Johansson in 2000 proved this convergence distribution, which basically says is that the last passage time between 0, 0 to n, n, this after centering by 4n and scaling by 2 to the 4/3 n to the 1/3, this converges in distribution to Tresividium 2. So this is a central limit type theorem. The fluctuation is n to the 1/3, not square root n. And the limiting distribution is GV Tresividium 2, not normal. And this is, if you recall, this is the marginal of Airy 2 as well. Okay. And we have the similar result for line to point passage time as well. The centering and scalings are same. and the limiting distribution is the scalar multiple of trace Vidom 1. Okay. And basically how this is proved was described in the previous talk. So it was for geometric last passage percolation, but one can take the limit to get it for this last passage percolation for exponential weight. So we saw that there is a combinatorial connection between this last passage percolation model, and one can get exact formulas to do that, to do this. And also, so these are equal in the distribution to largest eigenvalues of some random matrices. And analyzing these formulas, we get this convergence in distribution. Okay. Okay. So now I'll come to the Airy processes. So basically, this is how Airy process comes from the last passage percolation. So this is again my rotated direction, and this is my line x plus y equal to 2n. So I'm considering this point uns, which is basically s distance away from this n comma n. S distance away while the scaling is 2n to the 2/3. So this is basically my UNS point. And then one can define this TNS. So this is last passage time between 0, 0 to UNS. And TN star S, which is basically the last passage time from this line x plus y equal to 0 to this point. And these can be now viewed as a function on the real line. And these are the theorems that was proved, that as functions on real line, this TNS with this same centering and scaling converges in distribution to Airy 2 minus S square. And for the line to point passage time, this TN star S, after centering and scaling, this converges in distribution to the scalar multiple of Airy 1. So this is how Airy 1 and Airy 2 comes from this discrete model. Okay. So now I'll move to the fact that how we use this to prove the results about Airy 1 and Airy 2. So I'll just only describe the case for maximum of Airy 2, but all the other three cases will follow similarly. So what it basically, so using this limiting thing, one can show with little bit of work that it is enough to show this in this delimiting model. So basically we wanted to show that this maximum of Airy process by log t to the 2/3 grows like 3/4 to the 2/3. So basically what we will show, that this probability, we know that this quantity converges in distribution to Airy 2. So we will show that this maximum of this quantity over this interval is at much larger than 3/4 to the 2/3. This probability actually converges to zero, and this happens uniformly in T and N. And for the lower bound also, we will show that this maximum is not too small than 3/4 to the 2/3. This happens with positive probability, again uniformly in T and N. And if one can show these two, then that will imply the results for the limiting case, that is for the Airy 2. And to do this, two key points are sharp tail estimates and decorrelation in the correct scale. So I'll explain what these are. So for the sharp tail estimates, so we need to understand that what is the probability that this quantity is large. So for example, it was recently proved in a paper with Baslinker, Boshu and Krishnapur, that probability that this quantity is larger than x, this decays like exponential minus 4/3 x to the 3/2 with some epsilon error. And for the lower tail also, we have the result that it is smaller than minus x, this decays like exponential minus 1/12 x cube up to some epsilon error. So so this upper tail estimate is nothing new. So it could be, it can be analyzed using determinantal formulas, but such formulas are often difficult to analyze in case of lower tail. So what we basically use to prove this is some random matrix argument. Okay. So how do we use this is the following. So recall that we had to show that this probability that point to point last passage time over an interval t2n to the 2/3 is large. That is what we had to show. And we could discretize this interval basically into length of the smaller intervals 2n to the 2/3. And in each interval one can, so basically the idea is that this estimate for this point to point last passage time is true for the smaller intervals as well. So one can use those estimates to each of the smaller intervals to get that on each of these intervals, the probability that last passage time is large, it is at most 1/t to the sum 1 plus gamma. And then I take a union bound. So basically I get a 1/t to the gamma factor. So one gets that probability that the last passage time is large, that goes to zero uniformly in T and N. So that's basically the upper bound. So for the lower bound, we need to understand the decorrelation. So what it means is that So I have this x plus y equal to 2n line. So how far I have to go from a fixed point to show to see independence? So basically what happens here is that if there are two points on this line whose distance is much, much larger than n to the 2/3, then the passage time to them are sort of independent. So, and this is because these two are the geodesic two, these points, and these geodesic spends a large amount of time on two disjoint parallelograms. So that's why these two are roughly independent. And one can, so heuristically what it says is that if I take an interval of length t to n to the 2/3, then there are roughly t many independent scales over that interval. So what we basically do is that we approximate. So for the lower bound, we had to show that the point to point last passage time is not too small over an interval. So we basically approximate this event by union of t many independent events, and where each of these independent events has probability roughly like 1 by t. And that's how we conclude that it happens with a positive probability with uniformly in t and n. Okay, so that's more or less the proof and the problem. So this is the summary. So we consider these Airy processes, which arise as scaling limits of last passage percolation models with different initial conditions. And we argue in the pre-limiting LPP model to get a law of fractional logarithm for extrema of Airy processes over growing intervals. And as happens in the classical like proof of LIL, we here also we have two key ingredients. So that is, one is sharp tail estimates and the other is decorrelation in the correct scale. And so this decorrelation was the important part. So this was not so like analyzing the exact formulas of Airy processes was difficult to get this decorrelation, but one can use this LPP representation of this to get this decorrelation in the discrete case, and then one can transfer the result to the limiting case. And as I said, our proofs do not use the formulas for Airy processes, but we use these recently established sharp tail estimates and this decorrelation, which comes from the LPP geometry basically. And also there are other applications for these sharp estimates and LPP geometry. So we have also established a law of iterated logarithm. So this was also a previous paper, and where we actually get a log-log. So that's why it's iterated, and that happens because there the decorrelation happens at a slower scale. And again, we also use the same ingredients to show a law of fractional logarithm for the largest eigenvalues of GV minor process. So this actually solves a conjecture due to Packett and Zaituni. So this also we use the sharp tail estimates and the LPP geometry to get this. Okay, thank you.
Any questions or comments?
Maybe I missed part of the talk. Your methods are completely work the same for beta equal 1 and beta equal 2?
Sorry?
Your arguments work the same for beta equal 1 or, and beta equal 2? Or is there
The limits, you mean? Or
The methods, the arguments they work exactly the same?
It's the basic idea is exactly same with some modifications, but the arguments are same for beta equal to 1 and 2. So, yeah. So we use the point-to-point last passage time and line-to-point last passage time, but yeah, all the geometry type of arguments are similar for those two cases.
Thank you.
So you work with the last passage percolation model, but ultimately your results are for the
Airy processes.
Yeah. So is there a standard argument that takes any of these processes which has that convergence to? Is it the same kind of argument that would have worked for any other process, or is it
any other process? You mean from
which converges to?
But from other last passage percolation model to some other process?
Yeah,
it should, as long as we have these geodesic estimates and understanding of the it should.
Okay. Okay. If there are no further questions, let's thank the speaker.
Thank you.